Hey, you guys. Nice to have you back tonight. Hey, just wanted to kind of make a little disclaimer on this next video. You know, there's a lot of videos that are really entertaining to watch, and there's some that's kind of more informational or educational or whatever that way. And for those of you who may not be interested in engine building, this next video is probably going to be pretty boring for you. So it's kind of a long video. I try to edit stuff out, and long story made short, it's just hard to do because when I'm trying to learn something on YouTube or watch someone do something and they edit stuff out, it just drives me crazy because there's questions that I have. So what I've decided to do is just do a little disclaimer. If you're not really interested in seeing how an engine goes back together, you can kind of skip through this or even, you know, skip it. But if you're interested in how to put an engine back together, then you watch the whole thing. I'm not speeding it up. I'm just going to let it run kind of raw how I did it that day. You can kind of see my struggles and what took more time and so forth. So come on the journey if you want to watch the engine go back together. If not, it went back together fine. You can catch us on another video that might be a little more entertaining. So let's go for it, guys. Let's do this! Guess what tonight is? It's Thursday night. We're going to put this bad boy together. Everything's working okay. I'm ready to do this, okay? So I'm not going to show every piece of it because that'll just kind of bore everybody to tears. But basically what we're going to do is I'm going to clean off all the gasket surfaces initially with brake cleaner, then with acetone. I'm going to put the piston and the piston pin on here with the rings on. We're going to slide the cylinder down over the gasket, get it kind of set down. I do have to take the cam girdle and the cams out of the head so I can get the head bolts in. Before we put the head bolts in, we're going to lubricate the threads and the sealing surface of the washers with a little oil or assembly lube so that when you start tightening it down, they don't creak. When they creak, that affects your torque setting, okay? So we're going to do that. Let's see what else. Oh, I do like to use on the base gasket, I do like to use most of the time, 99% of the time, they use just a dry gasket, but I like using this Permatech ultra gray rigid high torque RTV sealant. It's great for oil. Great oil resistance. I put a very light coat. I use my finger to smooth it out, and then I put the gasket down, and then I do the same thing on the bottom of the cylinder, and then when I slide that baby down, seals up really good. The other thing is the head gasket. We do not use any sealant on that at all. That's designed to go on dry. It's got the ring right there, of course, compressor ring. But so here we go, everybody. Let's start this thing, eh? I'm gonna turn y'all off for a second. I'll turn it back on when I'm getting ready to assemble, okay? Okay, everybody, here's the point of no return. I think everything's ready. Everything's cleaned, ready to install. I might speed this video up. I don't know, it depends how long it takes me fighting it. So we're gonna start out with the, all surfaces are extremely clean now. I can't touch it with my fingers directly, but I'm going to go ahead and start with the gasket material. Go around every hole.
Sorry, I'm getting everybody's way here. Not to get any oil on your gasket. Got the cert clip in the other side. Dry fit it and test this. The rings are all oiled. This is the nightmare of all nightmares right here, you guys. If you hear me say bad words, that's because this little sucker right there went flinging across a room. Or the other reason. It's because I stabbed my finger with the screwdriver. as usual. That sucked.
Okay. Hand cleaner. Give you man hands like none other. Carburetor cleaner. Okay, I'm gonna put the goo on the back of this baby.
We just have to fight with the rings. I always do this by hand. I don't like breaking rings. Get a little rhythm here going, folks. One ring in. Two rings in. Rings in. Line the cylinder again with a little bit of oil. Folks, with a little tapping. Whoo! Quick little clean here again.
Make sure the intake side goes the intake side. Make sure you check your arrow on your piston going towards the exhaust. You guys, I'm sorry for being quiet. This is concentration time, homies. Another 8mm go. Okay, everybody, time to torque. Everything's kind of just finger tight down in there. I don't think I forgot anything. I sure hope to heck I didn't. We start with the four head bolts first, 11 foot-pounds. I'm going to go just a little snug here first. Notice no creaking on the bolts. That's good. And they squish them down nicely. Got to give Katsumi a little love here, y'all. And then we go to 34 foot-pounds. This is already set up. Katsumi needs a little lovin'. Just checking myself. Oh, baby. Baby. Whew. I hope everybody that this thing's right. Actually, it went together really smooth. So once you have everything prepared, that's about all the longer it takes. So I just got these two right here, 87 inch pounds. I do have to adjust this. Give me just a minute. I inherited this torque wrench right here from my wife's grandfather. He used to be a Snap-on dealer. 2, 4, 6, 8, 5, 87. He used to be a Snap-on dealer. And, see if I can speak English. And so when he passed away, the family all knows what a gearhead I am. So they made sure that I got the tools. Not all the tools, but a couple nice ones. This little 3/8 torque wrench I just love. Used it a lot. Oh, everybody, she's together. And there is compression. Okay, folks, I need to take a little brain break for a minute here, walk away, and get ready to start working on the valve train and the head, the valve train, and get all that stuff done so that I can get the tensioner in, get some other parts in here, and get it pretty well buttoned up. If I get this motor built tonight, I'll be a happy man. I'll be good with that. I can walk away and Saturday get some more stuff done. But as of right now, everything went together just the way we like it.